Hello everyone. Today's lesson is about pathophysiology of severe acute malnutrition in pediatrics. Malnutrition affects almost every organ system. It affects the immune system, the gastrointestinal system, integumentary system. It affects muscles. It affects wound healing. It affects the function of the kidney. It affects the brain reproduction, and also it affects impaired temperature regulation. So it almost affects every organ system. So let's start from the effect of malnutrition on the metabolic and the cellular changes. Malnutrition causes total body potassium to decrease, and it causes total body sodium to increase, because during severe acute malnutrition there is deficiency of ATP function. So sodium potassium ATPase pump fails to work, and it causes increased body sodium and decreased body potassium. And during severe acute malnutrition, low insulin action and diminished intracellular energy substrates reduce the availability of ATP and phosphocreatinine. This process probably alters the cellular exchange of sodium and potassium. And also during severe acute malnutrition, basal metabolic rate decreases by at least 30%. When we see the effect of severe acute malnutrition on the hematologic changes, there is reduction in hemoglobin concentration and red cell mass, and there is reduced hematopoietic activity. This is due to three reasons. Anemia in severe acute malnutrition occurs due to three reasons. The first one is due to reductive adaptation. Anemia due to reductive adaptation happens due to, one, since there is a decrement in basal metabolic rate by 30%, as we have said above, there is decreased oxygen requirement at the tissue level. This decreased oxygen requirement at the tissue level causes decreased need of oxygen. This decreased need of oxygen causes decreased production of erythropoietin at the kidney. This decreased erythropoietin production causes decreased hemoglobin. So anemia happens due to reductive adaptation. The other is during severe acute malnutrition, there is also lack of nutrition of vitamin B12, folate, and iron. So nutritional anemia can also happen during severe acute malnutrition. The other is in severe acute malnutrition patients, parasitic infection is common, such as hookworm. Those things causes anemia. When we see the effect of severe acute malnutrition on the cardiovascular changes, severe acute malnutrition causes cardiac output and the stroke volume to be reduced in a proportion to the loss of lean body mass. And central circulation takes precedency over peripheral circulation. And hemodynamic compensation occurs primarily from tachycardia. So severe acute malnutrition patients are at risk of heart failure if there is fluid overload. And this cardiac abnormality occurs due to different reasons. The first one is decreased cardiac output, hypotension, and bradycardia occurs due to cardiac muscle mass changes, as we have said. And Keshan disease, which is due to selenium deficiency, can cause cardiomyopathy. Selenium deficiency cardiomyopathy is called Keshan disease. And it might be associated with reduced cardiac output function. And arrhythmia occurs due to potassium, magnesium, and other electrolyte deficiency. When we see change in renal function, renal plasma flow and the glomerular filtration rates may be reduced, and water clearance and the ability to concentrate and acidify urine appear impaired. And also the other systemic manifestation of severe acute malnutrition is gastrointestinal changes. There is impaired intestinal absorption of lipids and the disaccharides. There is decrease in gastric, pancreatic, and bile production. There is intestinal villus atrophy. Those patients are at risk for diarrhea, and secretory and detoxifying functions of the liver is impaired, and the increased risk of hypoglycemia is there. The other is immune system changes. Severe acute malnutrition, major defects on immune system include there is a thymus gland atrophy, so T lymphocytes and the complement systems are significantly affected. And a marked depletion of lymphocytes is there due to, as we have said, due to thymus gland atrophy. And the complement system assessed by both the classic and alternative pathways, and the opsonic activity of the serum are depressed in severe proteinergic malnutrition. And the levels of B cells and immunoglobulins are relatively normal compared to that of T lymphocytes and complement level. The other is endocrine abnormalities. There is reduced insulin secretion and increased glucagon and epinephrine release. There is also increased secretion of human growth hormone and reduced somatomedin activity. And stress-induced secretion of epinephrine and cortisol, and also resistance to peripheral action of insulin is there. and there is decreased thyroxine level, and also there is decreased gonadotrophin level. And when we see the nervous system and the cognitive function in severe acute malnutrition, there is decreased brain growth, decreased nerve myelination, decreased neurotransmitter production, and the decreased velocity of nerve conduction in severe acute malnutrition. And environmental and the social support can improve behavior and the cognitive state. Just to discuss some of the clinical manifestations of severe acute malnutrition with their pathophysiology. From this, muscle wasting is common in marasmus or in non-edematous severe acute malnutrition. Muscle wasting occurs due to three reasons. The first one is calorie deficiency causes fats and the tissue proteins to be metabolized to supply energy for metabolic process. The second one is recurrent infection coupled with hypoglycemia causes acute stress response, cortisol released, and this causes wasting. The third one is most of the time there is underlying chronic infection in severe acute malnutrition children. This underlying chronic malnutrition causes muscle wasting. The other clinical manifestation of severe acute malnutrition includes edema. Edema occurs due to three reasons. The first one is protein deficiency is there during severe acute malnutrition. This causes hypoalbuminemia. This causes reduced plasma oncotic pressure, and the reduced plasma oncotic pressure causes fluid to shift to the interstitium and predispose for edema. The other is there is free radical damage to cell membrane, which causes sodium potassium ATPase malfunction and causes fluid leakage. And the third one is hypovolemia causes reduced GFR and activation of RAS system, and this causes sodium and water retention. Hypovolemia can happen from diarrhea, which is common in malnutrition patient, and also hypovolemia occurs from increased levels of leukotrienes. This causes vasodilation and causes secondary hypovolemia. This causes increased tubular reabsorption of salt and water, and that causes edema. The other important thing is edema grading in malnutrition. We say grade 1 edema if there is edema on both feet and ankle. We say grade 2 if there is edema on feet and the lower leg, and also on hands with arms. And we say grade 3 if there is edema on limbs and the trunk. And we say grade 4 if there is anasarca. The other important physical examination finding is hair change. This hair change occurs due to different reasons. From this, the first one is keratin synthesis impairment, because there is cysteine and methionine deficiency in severe acute malnutrition mostly. And cysteine and methionine is needed for production of keratin. So there is cysteine and methionine deficiency, which causes keratin synthesis impaired, and cause the hair to be brittle, and it causes the hair to be easily placable. The other is color change. The hair of severe acute malnutrition children, most of the time, it is reddish or gray. And this is due to pigment melanin deficiency, because pigment melanin is formed from tyrosine. So tyrosine deficiency leads to hair color change to reddish and gray. There is a period of good nutrition alternating with poor nutrition. That means there is a period of good protein intake alternating with poor protein intake, which causes the color of the hair to be different. This causes flag sign. And the dullness and the lack of luster due to weathering of the hair cuticle is seen. So hair changes is due to keratin synthesis impairment, due to pigment melanin deficiency, due to periods of good nutrition alternating with poor nutrition, which cause flag sign, and the other is due to weathering of the hair cuticle. The other clinical sign is on the skin change. Skin, there might be flaky painted dermatosis, which is hyperpigmented and hypopigmented areas, and the desquamation area over raw skin. This flaky painted dermatosis is thought to be due to zinc and niacin deficiency, and also it's thought to be due to free radical injury. And crazy pigment dermatosis occurs in some malnutrition children, and this is dry hyperkeratotic fissured skin with alternate areas of hyper and hypopigmentation. And atrophy of sweet and sebaceous glands leads to excessive dryness of the skin. And also acrodermatitis enteropathica can occur due to zinc deficiency. The other is most of severe acute malnutrition of pot belly abdomen or protuberant abdomen. This is due to four reasons. The first one is hypotonic muscles of the abdominal wall occurs due to muscle wasting. The other is paralytic sleds due to hypokalemia. Hypokalemia is common electrolyte abnormality in severe acute malnutrition. This hypokalemia causes paralytic illness, and it causes abdominal distension. The other is overgrowth of gas producing bacteria in the gut due to the reduced immunity. And the other is hepatomegaly due to fatty liver. The other important finding in most severe acute malnutrition children is hepatomegaly or fatty liver. This occurs due to free radical damage mitochondrial enzymes in the liver, causing reduced synthesis of protein. And from this protein, beta lipoprotein is one of them. So there is a reduced beta lipoprotein level, and this reduced beta lipoprotein level causes accumulation of triglycerides in the liver because of lack of breakdown of triglycerides. So free radical damage mitochondrial enzyme in the liver causing reduced synthesis of protein. This causes reduced beta lipoprotein, which causes increased triglycerides in the liver. This causes hepatomegaly. The other most clinical finding in severe acute malnutrition is diarrhea. Diarrhea occurs due to four reasons. The first one is there is a recurrent infection due to reduced immunity, because malnourished patients have reduced immunity, as we have said. They have decreased T lymphocytes and the complement levels, and also there are low secretory IgE levels. And this low secretory IgE levels, and also there is decreased gastric acid production, and low secretory IgE level with reduced secretion of acid in the stomach predispose for diarrhea. The other is there is malabsorption. As we have said, there is decreased pancreatic, gastric, and bile production. So from this, pancreatic enzyme deficiency resulting from pancreatic atrophy predispose for malabsorption and protein deficiency. And also there is villus atrophy, which causes reduced absorptive surface and predispose for loose stool and frequent passage of stool. The other is due to zinc deficiency, there is reduced gastrointestinal function, which causes chronic diarrhea. The other is apathy. Children with severe acute malnutrition are apathetic most of the time, and this occurs due to four reasons. The first one is hypokalemia. Hypokalemia causes muscle weakness and easy fatigability of muscles, and there is lack of stimulation and the deprivation, which causes reduced growth of brain and the nerve. So there is mental slowing and predispose the child for apathy. And there is decreased in zinc level, so zinc deficiency causes these symptoms, and there is a reduced basal metabolic rate up to 30%, which causes a child apathetic. Thank you for your attention. Don't forget to subscribe this channel.